Gary Green is joined by another one of the Buffalo Sabres, Ryan Miller, who has a little outdoor experience.
Well, Ryan, this isn't new to you. Back in your Michigan days, you experienced playing outdoors in a very historic game. So any advice that you've given to your teammates, first of all? I'm sure they've come to you on a number of occasions.
The biggest thing I've just been passing on is don't get caught up in the hype. You know, you got to go out and play a good hockey game, and that way you'll have a lot more fun and enjoy the memory of it looking back, knowing that you prepared and you went out to play just like another NHL game.
What can we expect as far as clothing from you tomorrow? I mean, Jose Theodore, he created the toque. You've got the toque on. You've got the piece underneath as well.
I'll claim mine. Mine's a hockey sock, you know, old school. Back when we were in juniors, we always had the, you know, go out and do running after practice. We grab the old hockey sock, throw it on the head. We'd even tape them to our arms sometimes because, you know, we didn't want to run in our big, thick coats, just a, you know, an extra layer. So kind of throw back to that. I got the hockey sock folded over, and, you know, we're selling them for my foundation, raise some money. You saw how well Jose's was a big hit. We figured, you know, we'd do a good thing and sell it on our website for our foundation, Steadfast Foundation.
When you think back to your game in Michigan and maybe back even further than that into your childhood, what is this playing outdoors? What did it mean to you then, and what does it mean to you today?
It's just the joy of hockey. You just usually get together with your friends, get out and play, and you go out and have fun. Just a sec.
We're just taking a brief moment here. Well, Ryan has decided that he better get out of the way of the Zamboni because he needs to let Amp Energy Zamboni through. And good heads up play there by you, Ryan.
Yeah, you don't want to get run over by the Zamboni. They teach you that pretty early.
Well, just getting back to your experiences and again playing outdoors, you mentioned the passion and what it really means to you.
Yeah, just outside, you associate that with your friends, neighborhood kids you grew up with. You'd find anything slippery to play on. And in our case, you know, sometimes it was a driveway that may have gotten iced over. Or at the golf course, there's a pond or two. And, you know, I got a little older. Our family lived up by a lake near Detroit. So, you know, my brother and I tried finding ways to resurface the ice with our dad's favorite beer cooler. I didn't like that too much. But it was fun, you know, good memories like that, being outside and trying to create an environment to play hockey. And, of course, you know, they went well out of their way to make this the grand stage, and we're excited.
Ryan, thank you very much for joining us. And take some pictures, too.
Oh, yeah.
Before the game. Thanks, Ryan. Let's go to Todd Lewis.
All right, with Jason Pominville also off the ice. How was it out there? As cold as you expected or nice?
Yeah, you know what? I didn't really know what to expect coming out here, but it was nice. I mean, obviously a little bit cold, but I was really surprised, really impressed with the ice. The ice was really good. I mean, it's fun. I think everything around this is exciting. Family and friends in town, and a lot of people have been talking about this this day, so I mean, we're excited for it to approaching.
Okay, you're one of the ones who have gone with the sock over the years to keep them covered up. Is it what you expected? Are you going to keep it for the game, do you think?
I don't know if I'm going to keep it. You know what, I probably won't. I can't hear as good as I would without it. I just want to keep myself warm for practice today, but tomorrow it'll probably be off.
Funny, that's something that nobody's really talked about yet, and being able to hear the shouts of your teammates and the yelling of the coaches occasionally as well.
Yeah, you know, it's something I noticed right away as I hopped on the ice. I couldn't hear as well as I would normally, and I just tried moving it a little bit, and it made a huge difference. So I think even though I'll probably be freezing, but it'll probably be off tomorrow.
All right, one more just before we let you go. Talk about your team, your season so far, and your performance so far.
Yeah, well, you know, obviously we didn't get the start we wanted to, but I think we've made some huge strides as a team, and we're slowly getting to where we want to be. And, I mean, we want to keep climbing, and, I mean, no better time than this. This is going to be great. And, I mean, against a team that's right up there with us in the standings, and a team we want to go ahead. So, I mean, we're excited, and hopefully we can get a win.
Jason, thanks so much for this. Good luck tomorrow.
All right, thank you.
All right. Welcome back to Ralph Wilson Stadium, Pittsburgh Penguins practice just coming to an end on the ice surface. And joining me, Sidney Crosby, captain of the Pittsburgh Penguins. Okay, let's get your impressions of the surface, the atmosphere, and what it's been like so far for you.
It's pretty cool. I mean, you come here, you see the setup, and the rink seems so small when you put it on a football stadium. But, you know, it's a lot of fun to be outside. And the ice hasn't been too bad. The weather's been good, so I don't think there's too many complaints.
A lot of smiles, a lot of laughter, a lot of joking around after practice, after the drills are done. Really seems like you guys are soaking this up and enjoying it for what it is.
Yeah, I don't know if we'll ever get this opportunity again, so definitely want to enjoy it, and I think we're all excited to have this opportunity You know, I said it before, but there could have been a lot of other teams in the league that had this chance, so I feel pretty fortunate.
As much fun as playing outside when you were a kid, but different, I guess.
Yeah, it's bringing back old memories, I guess, but you know, tomorrow there's going to be 2 points in line. It's a regular season game, too, so you have to keep that in mind, but you certainly have to enjoy it.
How about this Pittsburgh Penguins season so far? Not the start in the first half of the season that you would like, but last year you had a resurgence in the second half of the year and really carried that momentum into the playoffs.
I mean, I don't think we're doing too bad right now. I think we're pretty happy with the way things are going, and certainly expectations are high, so we have to make sure that each game we're ready and we're not going to surprise anyone, but at the same time, it's a tough league to win in, and I think we just have to maintain the same way we've played lately.
Wondered earlier if it's maybe the Pittsburgh Penguins aren't catching teams by surprise necessarily this year, that they saw your success late last year and everybody's kind of gunning for you this season.
That may be a bit of it. I think teams definitely are going to prepare maybe a little bit more because there's so much attention on our team, but we've had some injury troubles, and anytime you get that, it's always difficult, but we've done a pretty good job. Guys coming in and stepping up and coming together more as a team, and I think we've done a pretty good job.
Talk about yourself personally being named captain of the Pittsburgh Penguins this year. Has it changed your approach to how you approach the team and the game at all?
Not much. You know, you have to adjust a bit, and there's a bit of more responsibility as far as decisions and things like that go. But outside of that, I think everything's pretty much the same, and we have a pretty young team, and it's a good comfort level in the room, so I feel pretty fortunate to be a part of this group and have that comfort.
Nice to have somebody like Ty Conklin come in as well and play as well as he has after being called up.
Yeah, for sure. You have a goalie go down like we did with Mark, and you have two guys there that have played pretty solid. I think it brings a lot of confidence to your team when guys come in and do that. There's always a little bit of a question mark, so he's done a great job, and he's got some experience outside, which doesn't hurt in a game like this.
Yeah, true enough. Sidney, thanks so much for this. Enjoy the game tomorrow, and good luck.
Dave, thank you.
Sidney Crosby, captain of the Pittsburgh Penguins, just wrapping up practice. Let's go to Gary Green.
Well, I'll tell you, the practice has gone on a little bit longer than I thought it would have gone on because these players don't seem to want to get off the ice, but one player that is ready to get off the ice, but we're going to bring him in here. You know what? They always give me the Peterborough guys. I guess as a former Peterborough Pete's coach, they always say, get the Peterborough guys, which I don't mind at all. Jordan, how are you enjoying this experience? It's certainly probably much warmer than when you were growing up and playing in the outdoor lakes up in Thunder Bay, right?
Yeah, this is a treat for sure. It was a lot colder up in Thunder Bay and out in the rink and stuff like that, and we always had neck warmers on and stuff like that, but it's much the same, and it's fun being out here.
How's the ice, and are you going to ask your equipment manager to do anything different to your skates from an edges standpoint, or how are you going to have them sharpened for tomorrow?
To be honest, I think it felt pretty good. I think I'm not really going to change anything, skating. I think the snow builds up a little bit extra out here, but besides that, everything else feels pretty good.
When the snow is building up, which it tends to do in outdoor ice surfaces that we all experienced over our years, do you do anything differently as far as your game out there? I mean, do you hold the puck less? Do you use safer plays?
Yeah, just the old cliche, just keep it simple. I think, when you make, just don't make too many high-risk plays and just try to get the puck on net. And obviously, I don't think there's going to be too many pretty goals out here tomorrow. I think just as long as you keep it simple, I think we'll be fine.
I'm sure when it comes to goals, you'll take them any way you can get them right now. And you've had that sophomore jinx season that you probably heard so often all summer long, but it's been a little bit of a tougher season for you.
Yeah, it's been difficult. I think I just had a rough start, and I think lately, I'm feeling more confident there. And, I think just keeping my game simple and just getting pucks on net. And, I think they're going to go in sooner or later.
Jordan, thank you very much for joining us, and enjoy yourself and this experience, and good luck tomorrow.
All right, thanks a lot.